Today we are going to realize combinational based circuits, especially multiplexer circuits and demultiplexer circuits. Everyone here? Hello?
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Everyone here? Can you all hear my voice clearly?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes,
shall
yes.
I continue?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, a request to everyone, please mute your volumes. A request to everyone, please mute your volume so that you can hear me clearly. Requesting all to please mute your volumes. Okay, thank you. So today we are going to start with the multiplexer circuit. Well, a multiplexer is the one which allows us to choose n inputs for transmission to the output using m control bits. So if we have two inputs, we require one control bit. And today we are going to see the three types, that is 2:1 multiplexer, 4:1 multiplexer, and 8:1 multiplexer. You all can hear me? Hello? Hello? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is the general form. I will pause in between so that if anyone wants to write it down, you all can write it down. So this is the general form of a multiplexer circuit. It has many inputs, only one output, and the control line will select which inputs will go to the output. Okay, can I move on to the next slide?
Yes.
Yes.
So now we will start with 2:1 multiplexer implementation using N-pass transistor. Now N-pass transistor means only NMOS transistors will be required here. So let us start with the 2:1 multiplexer general block. A 2:1 general block of multiplexer looks something like this. It has two inputs, I0 and I1, and it has only one output, and S0 is my control line. Further, I will see the truth table and the output expression of the same. Now the truth table is as follows. Whenever S0 is 0, my I0 line is selected at the input and it is power proceeded to the output. So my F is I0. When my S0 is 1, my I1 is available at the output. So the output expression will be, in this case, looking at the truth table, it will be F is equal to S0 bar into I0 plus S0 into I1. So this is here the output expression is. Everyone able to follow?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do you all want me to pause or you want to write something?
No.
Done.
Okay. Okay, this is just whatever I have told you just now. If S0 is 0, my output is I0, which is available. And my S0 is 1, my output is I1, which is available. Now, this logic expression we have to implement using only NMOS transistors. So, here is my implementation. So, as we know already, in an NMOS pass transistor, whatever we pass at the input is passed at the output. Whenever the control signal applied at the gate terminal is logic 1 or VDD. So in this case, in the upper transistor, if S0 is equal to 0, means 0 bar, that is 1, is applied to the gate. So it will pass I0. Whatever is I0 is, I0 can be 1 or 0. So it will pass as it is at the output. The entire expression also contains S0 into I1. So in the second transistor configuration, I have connected S0 to the gate So when S naught is zero, this transistor is not on. This transistor is off, and this transistor is only on. So at a time, only one transistor will work. So when the case S naught is equal to one, my upper transistor is off and my lower transistor is on. So it will pass I1 as it is to the output. So that explains the truth table of this 2:1 implementation using pass transistor logic. Everyone following?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So this is one of the implementation of 2:1 multiplexer using N-pass transistor logic. Now I also want to show you the circuit simulation of this using LTSpice. This one. So kindly concentrate. Requesting all to please mute your volume.
Hello.
Hello, yeah. Hello, yes. Okay, can you all see the circuit diagram in LTSpice?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the same thing which I have implemented over here. I0 and I1 are my two inputs. F is one of the output, and I've applied S0 bar and S1 at the two gate terminals of my NMOS transistor. And this is my expression. Remember, in BVLSI IA1 also, whenever there are complementary signals, you have to always use a CMOS transistor to implement it. Don't directly implement S0 and S0 bar. It is logically wrong. And always have a practice of writing the total transistor count. So in this case, the number of transistors are 2 for the CMOS inverter and 2 for the implementation of 2:1 multiplexer. So the transistor count over here is 4. So always keep a habit of always writing the transistor number of transistors used in a particular logic. Okay, so here also one more thing I want to add. While I show you the waveforms, all the inputs in any logic expression should be not overlapping with each other. If they are overlapping, there will be a slight glitch in the output, as many of you might have observed while trying IA1. So here is the waveforms which I want to show you. I'll add plane plots because I have more than one input and one output. So kindly label them properly here, so that as per your names, so that it is visible at the output waveforms while solving IA1. So I am plotting S0, I0, I1. As you can see, in this tree, these three are my inputs. S0 is my select line. I0 and I1 are my two inputs. As you can see clearly from this waveforms, all three are non-overlapping. Now, non-overlapping means they cannot start or they cannot rise or fall at the same time. That means if the input is making a transition of 1 to 0, all of them should start differently. And if the input is making a transition of 0 to 1, also they should start differently. So as you can see from this, it is evident here. So kindly follow this while solving your IA1. Now we'll check the output. This is the expected output over here. So as per our truth table, whenever S0 is 1, it will pass I0, and whenever S0 is 0, it should pass I1. S0 is 0, it will pass I0. S0 is 1, it will pass I1. There is only a slight glitch which you can see in the waveforms which I have written already here. Now this only is a special case which is happening whenever S0 is changing from 1 to 0 and when both I1 and I0 are 1. So why this is happening? Because both the transistors are trying to go to 1 simultaneously, because here at this point of time, S0 is 1 and 0 simultaneously here in this case. That's why the output has a slight glitch. So only in this case it is assumed there will be no such glitch in case of transmission gates. Now, what is the limitation of this circuit? The limitation of using N-pass transistor logic is, if I have used the dot model statement and I have given the threshold voltage of this NMOS as 0.7, the maximum output voltage available will be VDD minus 0.7. So the output voltage available, so it's not 5 volts as you can see from here. Inputs are reaching from 0 to 5, but output is reaching from max to 0 to 4.3. I'll check it over here whether it is 0 to 4.3 or no. Can you all see over here 4.3 volts max? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so this is the limitation of this circuit. In NMOS transistor, pass transistor logic, you never get a full swing. It passes 0 as it is, but it fails to pass 1 as it is. Okay, so shall we proceed with the PMOS transistor logic?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this is just a thing which I have already repeated. NMOS pass transistor passes a strong 0 while it passes a weak 1. And we have already seen this circuit implementation. And the only limitation of N-pass transistor is the maximum output voltage achieved is VDD minus VT on, as we have seen in the circuit waveforms. Now we move on to the 2:1 multiplexer using P-pass transistor logic. Now the functionality will be exactly the same, only the implementation part, instead of using only NMOS transistors, we'll use only your PMOS transistors. So here is the implementation. So in this case, as you can notice, S0 bar and S0 has interchanged their position, because a PMOS transistor is on when we apply 0 to its gate terminal. So whenever we apply 0 to the gate terminal, it will pass whatever is at the input. Important thing to note is, how do we determine which is the source and the drain terminal in a NMOS or a PMOS? In this case, both the terminals, you can pass it interchangeably. Meaning, if this is the source, this can be drain. And if this is the drain, this can be source. It's a pass transistor. It passes from any side. You all can try it in your lab also. So in this case, whenever S0 is 0, the upper transistor M1 is on and it passes I0 to the output. Similarly, when S0 is 1, my lower transistor becomes on and it passes I1. So your limitation here in this case in PMOS transistor is, it passes a strong logic 1 but a weak logic 0, because the output is limited to VTOP. And I have written here it is rarely used. Now, PMOS logic in digital logic design is rarely used because NMOS transistors are made up of main electrons and PMOS transistors are made up of P channel, which is consisting of holes. Now, if you see carefully, NMOS has a mobility which is around twice the mobility of holes. So, if you have a circuit consisting of NMOS transistors, and you compare a circuit consisting of a PMOS transistors, NMOS transistor circuits will be much, much faster. So we don't preferably use P-pass transistor logic much often. That's why I have written over here, rarely used. Are you all following?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
So similarly, you all can implement this in LTSpice. I'm not going to show you LTSpice simulation of this. It's exactly the same.
Yes, sir.
Now we move on to the next topic. 4:1 multiplexer using N-pass transistor logic. So here is my general block. 4:1 multiplexer. It has 4 inputs, 1 output, and 2 control lines or select lines to select one of the inputs and be available at the output. The truth table for the same is as follows. So whenever the combination of S0 and S1 is 0, 0, I1 is available at the output. When S0 and S1 combination is 0, 1, I1 is available at the output. When S0 and S1 combination is 1, 0, I2 is available. And when they are 1, 1, S0 and S1, available output is I3, which is the input. And now we will see what will be the expression, output expression. As you can see, you can determine the output expression from the truth table. 0 means it will be S0 bar. Again, 0 means it will be S1 bar. So the first term will contain S1, S0 bar, S1 bar into I0. Second term will be S0 bar S1 into I1 plus the third term will be S0 S1 bar into I2. Then the fourth term will be S0 S1 into I3. Now, basically, we have to implement your 4:1 mux usually realizing this expression using N-pass transistor logic. So whatever concepts we have developed earlier, we will apply it now here. So the circuit realization is as follows. Similar to whatever we have achieved earlier, here in this case, we have 2 inputs here. 3 inputs basically, S0, S1 and I0. So we will have one NMOS transistor. So this NMOS transistor will be on whenever S0 is 0 and it will pass I0. So that at the output you will have this expression. Now we don't have only I0 into S0 bar, we have S1 bar also. So we can implement this by cascading them together. So if we cascade 2 N-pass transistors this way, so this transistor will be on whenever S0 is 0, so it will pass I0. And this second transistor will be on whenever S1 is also 0 and it will pass I0. So this is the scenario. This is the case one of the truth table. Whenever S0 and S1 is 0, that time the available output is I0. I0 can be 0 or 1. So in this way, you all can build it up. I have not shown the complete realization because it is a part of IA1. So you all can try it and do it systematically at your own pace. You all can apply I1, I2, I3, add them all together and realize this circuit in LTSpice to get the desired output. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I am just showing you the circuit realization in a glance. Together, it will look something like this. Okay, so we'll move on to the next topic, that is 2:1 multiplexer using transmission gates. Now, 2:1 multiplexer, the other name for it is 2-line to 1-line data selector. In the literature, they call it this name also. So we should be aware of it. Right now, I'm using some different terminology for the inputs, M0 and M1. My S0 remains the select line and we have one output F. Now the truth table for the same is same. Only thing is here I've changed the terminology of inputs. So my S0 is 0, available output is M0. My S0 is 1, available output is M1. Now we have to realize the same logic using transmission gate now. All of you are aware of transmission gate. It passes a strong 0 and a strong 1. And the symbol for the same is as follows. So this is my symbol of a transmission gate. Now how this works is, can you all see this S0 and S0 bar? Is it available? Okay, so how does this work? How does this work, the transmission gate 1? First, I'll explain you this working in short and then explain you the full circuit realization. Here, this transmission gate will pass M0 only when S0 is 0. So if S0 is 0 and S0 bar will be 1, so this transmission gate will be on, then only it will pass this M0 to the output here. So what will happen when S0 is 1? When S0 is 1 and S0 will be 0, this transmission gate is off and we set it to be in the high impedance state. Okay? So in this case, when the truth in the truth table, if S0 is 0, the output available should be M0, which is happening in this case. So the whole circuit realization, entire circuit realization is as follows. So as you can see, whenever S0 is 0, the upper transmission gate is on and the lower transmission gate is off. And at the output, you have M0. And whenever S0 is 1, this is off, upper transmission gate is off, lower transmission gate is on, because you are applying 1 over here, 0 over here, which will turn on this transmission gate and it will pass as it is M1. So this is the circuit realization of 2:1 multiplexer using transmission gate. Anyone has any query?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, good. So we will proceed with one circuit realization.
No, sir.
Hello? Anyone has any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. So, I'll proceed with okay, anyone? Any questions? Okay, so if you all have no questions, we'll proceed with the LTSpice simulation of the same. So here is my transmission gate realization of 2:1 multiplexer. Whatever we have explained, here I have given I0 and I1. I'll just show you the output. So I will plot my S0 first. Requesting all to please mute your volume. Requesting all to please mute your volume.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I am expanding this and I'll explain you this in a minute. So as you can see again, all my three inputs, I0, I1, and S0, are non-overlapping. Y'all can check. They are not starting or ending at the same point. So this will ensure there is no glitches in the output. Now, in this case, the transmission gate has the advantage of passing 0 and 1 strongly. As you can see in the output waveform, it is passing from 0 to 5. Y'all can see this? Can y'all see this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes,
just to be sure, you can see this 5 volts output over here. Now let's check the combination over here, whether it passes I0 and I1 correctly or no. So in the logic expression, if S0 is 0, it should pass I0 as it is. As you can see, whenever S0 is 0 over here, I0 is this, and it passes as it is I0. Whenever S0 is 1, it should pass only I1. So as you can see, whenever S0 is 1 over here, from here to here, it is passing only I1. And similarly, you all can verify the remaining waveforms. All of you comfortable with it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so I will proceed. Yes. I'll proceed with the topic. Here is, you all read it for mostly around 10 seconds. This is what I've described. I'll start in 10 seconds. Okay. So the advantage of transmission gate is very obvious. The output has a full swing from 0 to VDD. But the only limitation over here is The number of transistors required over here are very large. In the last example, simulating example, which we have seen, the number of transistors required here, required to implement this was how many? Two for this, that is four, and also one more for, two more for this bar. So total transistor requirement here is six.
Six.
Which is a limitation. So transistor count increases as soon as we use transmission gates. But on the brighter side, it provides full swing output.
Yes.
Everyone comfortable with it?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
So, now we'll move on to 4:1 implementation using transmission gate. Requesting again all of you to please mute your volume. Requesting all of you to please mute your volume. Yeah, thank you. So, similar to 2:1 multiplexer using transmission gate, we'll implement 4:1 multiplexer using the similar logic. So, my truth table, which you have already seen earlier, my multiplexer general block, it has four inputs, one output and two select line. And this is my logic expression. Now, this time, we have to implement this using transmission gates. So, the implementation is as follows. So I have a S0 bar. See, really, whenever we draw a NOT gate, we should write this thing. Really, it's a CMOS inverter and we are drawing it just for simplicity. So while you do it in your lab or LTSpice, always use a CMOS inverter to implement complementary signals. Okay? Hello, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we'll try to implement the first part of the expression. That is S0 bar, S1 bar, I0. So this is a little different circuit realization. We first have drawn a line of parallel line of S0 bar, then S1 and S1 bar. And then I have added transmission gate in the middle of these two. Okay, so let us see the working. So in the first transmission gate, I have connected S0 bar over here and S0 over here. So whenever S0 is zero, this transmission gate will work and will pass I0. And this transmission gate will be on whenever S1 is zero. So S1 is zero, again, this transmission gate will work and will pass I0 as it is. So this completes the first part of the truth table, which is this. When S0 and S1 are 0, 0, my output available is I0. Now let us see the second part. S0 is 0, S1 is 1. So in this case, if my S0 is 0, S0 is 0 means you apply 0 over here, 1 over here. So this transmission gate is on and it will pass I1 as it is. Now to turn this transmission gate on, we need to apply S1 as 1. So if we apply S1 as 1, this is connected to S1 bar. So this becomes 0 and this is 1. So this turns on this transmission gate. Hence the output available will be I1. Everyone following?
Yes, sir.
So this way, similarly, you all can implement. I cannot show you all the implementation of this because it is one of the IA1 questions. So I have shown you two. Similarly, you all can implement I2 and I3 and realize the complete 4:1 multiplexer circuit. Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we'll take a break of 30 seconds. We'll resume after 30 seconds. The next topic of discussion will be decoder circuits.
Okay, sir. Bye.